Good morning, one and all. In this today's video lesson, we will mainly discuss regarding two important applications of power electronic devices: light dimmer circuit and burglar alarm circuit. Actually, in this power electronics video lessons, first of all, we have mainly focused on the thyristor family devices like SCR, GTO, DIAC, TRIAC, IGBT, MOSFET. After briefly discussing regarding these devices, then we come across the simple power electronic circuits like converters, choppers, AC voltage controllers, inverters, cyclo converters we have discussed. After discussing these power electronic circuits, now we are going to enter into practical applications of these power electronic circuits. Actually, with the invention of thyristors, the thyristors are widely used in many number of applications in the field of power electronics. So we will discuss few of those applications like high voltage direct current transmission systems, light dimmers in homes and theaters. Actually, in cinema halls we will see these light dimmers especially. So before entering into the theater, so before starting the cinema, after entering the theater, we will see the intensity of light will be lower and slowly it will be decreases when the movie starts. Similarly, a light charging, that is a battery charging circuits, generally these will be used in UPS inverters where you are having battery, a DC source. For charging of batteries, we are using the power electronic circuits. So there you are having converter and a filter will be there, so that converts actually available alternating current into DC current. A burglar alarm circuit, that we will discuss these two, light dimmer circuit and burglar alarm circuit, in detail in this today's video lesson. And some different applications like lighting, breakers, electric traction, and these are the different few applications of the power electronic circuits. In that we will mainly focus on two: light dimmer circuit and burglar alarm circuit. In this previous class, we have started the applications of power electronic circuits in chapter, in this chapter. And in this, we have mainly focused on switch mode power supply, SMPS. SMPS, actually, what are the different problems available in raw main electrical AC power supply and how to alleviate those problems by using SMPS, the block diagram of SMPS, and what are the main advantages and disadvantages of SMPS, we have seen in this chapter. After that, we come across the concept of UPS. UPS is nothing but uninterrupted power supply. Actually, in most of the cases, we are going with inverters. In most of the homes recently, due to load shedding problems, in most of the houses, we are installing inverters. But due to switching speeds, some critical loads will be having UPS, having backup power supply with the UPS, uninterrupted power supply. Actually, how that UPS will be working, what are the main types of UPS, like online UPS and offline UPS. So how to estimate the required rating of inverter, battery, UPS, we have discussed in the previous video lessons. And now we will mainly focus on regarding the applications of power training device, and we will see some important topic, the storage batteries, concept of storage batteries. We need to calculate the capacity of storage batteries, and then we will go for that one. So in this today's class, we will mainly focus on the types of batteries used in UPS. So this is the topic which is left in UPS. So first of all, we'll complete this types of batteries which are used in UPS, and the applications of storage batteries. Now we will switch over to applications of power training circuits. That is, first one is light dimmer circuit using DIAC and TRIAC. And next one is the burglar alarm circuit. So it is also called as the theft alarm. Now we will see regarding storage batteries used in UPS. Storage batteries are nothing but it will store the electrical energy in the form of direct current. And what are the different types and how these will operate, we are going to see. Actually, this storage battery is a very important part of inverter system in UPS, because the absence of power, the energy stored in these storage batteries will be used. It will be converted into AC and supplied to the critical load. So it is playing a vital role. Now, whenever the low and short backup periods, suppose if the power failure is for up to 30 minutes or less than 1 hour, then like that periods are called short backup periods. Sealed maintenance free batteries are used. Sealed maintenance free batteries are used with UPS, because these are having longer life, as a sealed maintenance free batteries will be having longer life, and we need not to do the change of contact plates, and there won't be any problem like adding of that H2SO4, like that there won't be any addition of distilled water. So such kind of problems may not be frequently occurring in maintenance free batteries. That dilute H2SO4 will be added as a electrolyte, so we are need not to adding such kind of maintenance in maintenance free batteries. So that's why for short backup periods we are using sealed maintenance free batteries for UPS. For the smaller power of times, that is up to 1 hour. For medium power UPS, and the ampere hour capacity is around 7 ampere hour, is sufficient to provide a backup for about half an hour. So for this capacity, these sealed maintenance free batteries will be sufficient to provide backup power for half an hour. And the selection of the battery capacity will be depend on these factors. Mainly, first one is nature of load, which type of load we are using, and the capital investment, how much money we need to invest. So based on that, we are selecting the required battery, storage battery, type of battery we are using, and the backup period, how much time. So is there any continuous requirement of battery, or it may be required for a smaller amount of time. So depending on the local area of concerned distribution system, so it will be there. And the efficiency of the battery is also one of the key factor while selecting the battery. So whenever low and short backup periods are the requirements, so in that cases we are going for sealed maintenance free batteries. sealed maintenance free batteries. So SMF full form will be sealed maintenance free battery. So for low end short backup periods, we are going with sealed maintenance free batteries are used. And whenever require higher rating and larger backups, we are going with the lead acid batteries. The rating is more, then we are switching over to higher ratings. We are going for lead acid batteries. For higher rating and large backup periods, lead acid batteries are used. These are either parallel plate or tubular type. The sealed maintenance free batteries are costlier than the lead acid batteries but have longer life, about 4 to 6 years. Coming to specifications of batteries, the main specifications of batteries are EMF. EMF rating will be 6 volts, in the range of 6 volts, 12 volts or 24 volts. And the terminal voltage will be around 1.8 volts for single cell and 5.4 volts in case of 6 volts battery. Internal resistance, it is of the order of 0.01 ohms, so very small internal resistance. And the capacity of the battery, it is the quantity of electricity the cell can give during single discharge until terminal voltage falls to 1.8 volts. The ampere hour efficiency, it is around 90%. And watt hour efficiency is typically around 75%. So these are the main specifications of storage batteries. Now we will switch over to applications of power electronic circuits. As like we have discussed, main applications of power electronic circuits are, these are used in different electrical power applications, electrical and electronic applications, as the thyristors are widely used in many number of applications in the field of power electronics. And these are the few applications of the power electronic circuits. They are mainly HVDC transmission systems, high voltage direct current transmission systems, and light dimmers. These are used in homes and theaters. And light charging and battery charging circuits. And this one, burglar alarm circuit, burglar alarm or theft alarm circuits. And these are used in electric traction vehicles such as tram cars, trolley cars, subways, electro locomotives, etc. And these are used in commercial lighting and also speed control of AC and DC machines, static circuit breakers, and also in power supply of aircrafts. Along with this, these are used in power control in chemical processing using electrochemical process such as electrolysis, power control in metallurgical process using electrothermal processes such as electro arc melting, arc welding, induction heating and melting, resistance heating, etc. And the last one is like power supply of aircrafts, space shuttles, and satellites. So in these different applications, the powertronic circuits will be used. So now we will switch over to the applications. We will discuss one by one. So in our syllabus, we are having the light dimmers, burglar alarm circuits, emergency lamp circuit, and the battery charging circuits. So we will focus on this thing. And this question is very important for the SBDT exams is concerned. They will ask list the applications of powertronic circuits. So we need to remember at least six of the applications. Now we will switch over to light dimmer circuit using DIAC and TRIAC. Light dimmer means it will change the intensity of light. So we are using different powertronic components like TRIAC. By using this thing, we will send the required voltage to lamp. So by changing or adjusting the voltage to the lamp, the intensity of lamp will be controlled. So that is the light dimmer circuit. So how it will be operating by using this DIAC and TRIAC circuit, we will discuss in this video lesson. So this is the connection diagram of light dimmer circuit using DIAC and TRIAC. It mainly consists of the lamp and TRIAC and DIAC. Along with these things, we are also having a rheostat, nothing but a variable resistance, and a capacitance, and a resistor R1. It is a safety purpose, and a switch which is connected to a main circuit, single phase AC main circuit. Okay, so normally this switch is in open position. Now we will discuss the operation of this light dimmer circuit. Mainly this circuit is used to control the illumination level of lamp using DIAC and TRIAC. So here we are having the RC circuit. So this RC circuit will be forming the triggering circuit of DIAC, and these three, the RC circuit and the DIAC, will be forming the triggering circuit of TRIAC. So whenever the supply is present and when we are closing the switch, the TRIAC will be forward biased. TRIAC will be forward biased both during positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So TRIAC will be forward biased, but it is not conducting. So whenever the TRIAC is in conduction, so in that case the supply will be flowing through TRIAC and lamp, and the lamp will illuminate. So the TRIAC conduction is according to the firing signal generated by this circuit. So this circuit will form the firing circuit to the TRIAC. So this firing circuit will be activated when the DIAC is in conduction. So the conduction of DIAC is with respect to the RC circuit. Okay. So initially, when the switch is closed, the current will be flowing through this R1 and this variable resistor and capacitor, and it will go into the supply mains. And whenever the current is going in this path, the capacitor will be charges. When the capacitor is having sufficient voltage to trigger the DIAC, then the DIAC will conduct. When the DIAC conducts, the capacitor voltage will be applied across the gate circuit of TRIAC, and the TRIAC conducts. When the track conducts, the current will be flowing through supply AC mains through track, and the lamp, it will goes to negative terminal and the lamp will become glow. This is how the light dimmer circuit will operate. So this instant of conduction is according to the RC circuit. So if the resistance is higher, then small currents will be flowing through this capacitor, and capacitor charging time will be increases, then the firing will become delayed. When the firing will become delayed, the lamp will glow at a later stage. And if this R value is reduced, then the charging of capacitor will occur in a faster rate, and the lamp will illuminate with more brighter. So this is for the safety purpose. Resistance R1 mainly, if the this rheostat resistance is minimum, there will be huge currents, high currents will be flowing through the track, which may be more than the gate current of track circuit. So this may damage the gate circuit. To avoid the problem, we are connecting a resistance in series with the RC circuit for safety purpose. So the intensity of lamp will be controlled by changing the resistance. The resistance is at lower value, the intensity of lamp will be more. The resistance is at higher value, the current decreases, so capacitor charges with at a lower rate, and because of that delay will become more, and the lamp intensity decreases as the track triggers at later stages. This is how the lamp dimmer circuit will operate. Mainly the RC circuit forms the triggering circuit for the diac. When the voltage across capacitor is sufficient to cause conduction of diac, the gate current flows through the gate circuit of triac. The triac starts conducting and the lamp glows. Changing resistance R causes change in firing angle of triac, and the voltage applied to the lamp changes, thus changes the illumination level. The fixed resistance R1 ensures that gate current does not become more than the rated current, even when the resistance R is at minimum value. So this is the circuit operation of the light dimmer circuit. We will see this operation, working of light dimmer circuit. The voltage across capacitor is sufficient to cause the conduction of diac. A gate current flows in the gate circuit of triac. The triac starts conducting and the lamp glows. A changing resistance R causes the change in firing angle of triac, and the voltage applied to the lamp changes and changes its illumination level. The fixed resistance R1 ensures the gate current does not become more than the rated current, even when the resistance R is at minimum value. When the R is at minimum value, it should be taking this fixed resistance R1 is taking precaution such that the rated current, the gate current, does not exceeding the rated current of the gate circuit. So that's why we are connecting the fixed resistance R1 in series with the RC circuit. So this is how the light dimmer circuit will operate. So this is mainly used in the cinema halls and the homes, especially in places where we require pleasant lighting. In that case, we are going with these light dimmer circuits. It will be mainly used to control the illumination level of a lamp by using the firing circuit of triac. So mainly here we are using triac for to have control in both the half cycles, that is during positive half cycle of supply and negative half cycle of supply. The same operation will be done with respect to negative half cycle also. So we are having control in both the positive as well as negative half cycle of the supply. Now we will switch over to burglar alarm circuit. Actually, this burglar alarm is an electronic device which is fixed at some concealed point that rings a loud bell if somebody tries to theft the equipments. And this is also called as theft alarm. Is there any unwanted persons will come or enters into that, the alarm will blow. Example like lockers or in banks or in some secret places where it is required security. So in that case, we are placing the burglar alarm. So it is also used as called as theft alarm. Generally it will be placed in the car tape decks. So if the thief will come and pulls the car tape deck, then it is giving alarm so that the thief will get arrested, or it will be giving signal to the persons who are in surrounding. So everyone will get alerted. For safety purpose, we are using this burglar alarm circuit. Now we are going to see the operation of this burglar alarm. So this is the connection diagram of the burglar alarm. It will be mainly consisting of the thyristor, that is SCR, and we are having a resistance and a capacitance. Here this gate circuit will be normally grounded through this tape deck, and here we are having a switch which is connected to the horn, and this circuit will be connected with a single phase AC supply. Okay, so this horn will be in series with the single phase AC supply and the switch through thyristor. And this gate circuit will be normally connected to grounded in normal operation. So these are the different parts existing in the burglar alarm circuit. Now we will discuss the circuit operation of this burglar alarm. Normally this tape deck plug is connected like this. So whenever this circuit is closed, the gate circuit will be connected to grounded. So the SCR will not conduct. The SCR is already forward biased state, but it is not conducting as it is not received the gate signal. Because the gate circuit is grounded through tape deck plug. But if a thief comes and pulls the tape deck from car, then the circuit will become open and this gate will get supply through resistance are from the main supply. From main supply through resistance R, the gate will energized and the gate circuit will connected, so SCR will be triggered. As a gate circuit is operating, it is giving trigger pulse to the SCR and the SCR will be conducting. When SCR is conducting, it is acting like a closed switch. As this switch is already closed, the SCR is acting like a closed switch. The horn will start blowing. The burglar alarm will start blowing. And this process will continue until the switch is opened. So this is how the operation of bulk burglar alarm circuit will be there. So mainly this burglar alarm circuit will be used for protecting a car tape deck from theft. The switch S is located at some concealed point in the car and it is kept closed. Since gate is grounded through the tape deck, the SCR is in off condition and the horn is in silent. The tape deck is removed, the gate is no longer grounded. Instead, it gets connected to the car battery through a resistance R. Consequently, the gate current is set up which fires the SCR. As a result, the horn starts blowing and continues to do until the switch is again opened. So this is how the burglar alarm circuit will operate. So this is very important application of powertronic circuit, where the car tape deck is protected. And not only this, it will be used in various applications where the secrecy has to be maintained, like locker rooms, banks, and some other treasury places. This theft alarm will be used. We will see this operation. Burglar alarm is an electronic device. It is fixed at some concealed point that rings a loud bell. If someone enters to theft the equipment that carries, that this circuit gives an alarm signal. If anyone tries to theft the equipment, then the circuit will give the alarm signal. So it is also called as the theft alarm. Switch S is located at some concealed point and kept closed. The gate G is grounded. The SCR is off and horn is silent. The equipment is connected in circuit is removed. The gate is no longer grounded. It gets connected through battery through R. The gate is connected through car battery through a resistance R. The gate current is set up which triggers the SCR. As a result, the horn starts blowing and continues to do until switch is opened. So this is how the burglar alarm circuit will operate. So this is regarding burglar alarm circuit, which is mainly used for avoid thefting of valuable things. So in this today's class, we have mainly focused on the discussion of different storage batteries used in UPS and their applications. Mainly sealed maintenance free batteries will be used for shorter duration of power failures and lower rating. And whenever higher rating is required, we are going with lead acid batteries. for lower and short backup periods. Sealed maintenance free batteries are used, and for higher ratings, large backup period lead acid batteries are used. And we have discussed the important application of powertronic circuit, the light dimmer circuit consisting of diac and triac. Diac and triac used. By changing the firing angle of triac, the voltage applied can be controlled, thereby the intensity of lamp will be changed. That is, the dimming of lamp will be controlled. And we have also seen regarding the SCR circuit, which is used for burglar alarm or theft alarm. Best example for this application is prevention of music systems in the car to avoid theft. Batteries are used to support the circuit. So based on these two applications, we will attempt a small quiz. For low and short backup periods of UPS, the battery used is low and short backup periods of UPS. SMF battery, lead acid battery, tubular battery, parallel battery. For low and short backup, we are going for SMF, sealed maintenance free batteries. So option A is correct one. Sealed maintenance free batteries. Generally, we are using the sealed maintenance free batteries for lower and short backup periods of UPS. Selection of rating of battery depends on nature of load, backup period, capital investment, all of the above. So it will depends on all these factors: type of load, backup period, capital investment. So option D, all of the above for selection of battery. In light dimmer circuit, R1 fixed resistance is used to, option A, ensure gate current does not become more, ensure gate current does not become less, ensure gate voltage does not become more, ensure gate voltage does not become more. Actually, it is mainly focusing on gate protection. So gate current should be having some specific maximum value that should not be exceeded. So for gate current limiting, it is using the fixed resistance. So option A, it ensures the gate current should not become more. So in that purpose, the fixed resistance is connected in the circuit. The changing resistance R causes change in firing angle of diac, triac, capacitor, lamp. So actually it will affect the connection of triac, but before connection of triac we should have the diac. So first the diac has to be triggered, then it is triggering the triac. So the changing of resistance will affect mainly the triac. So when the triac conducts, it is connected to the load. So when the firing angle is with respect to diac, triac has to be connected with respect to the diac. So diac conduction is according to the RC circuit. So mainly it is for the firing angle is depends on the triac conduction. So the changing resistance is according to the intensity of voltage required. For that, we are choosing the value of resistance R. For a thyristor, the following is grounded in burglar alarm application. Option A, anode. Option B, cathode. Option C, gate. Option D, none of the above. So generally, gate circuit will be grounded. Option C. So in this today's videos class, frequently asked questions are list to the different types of batteries which are used in UPS. So we have to write the different storage batteries, sealed maintenance free batteries, and lead acid batteries. Try and explain the light dimmer circuit using diag and triag. First, we have to draw the neat circuit diagram, and we have to mention the parts existing in that one, components existing, and we have to explain the operation. And they are asking another question on try and explain the theft alarm circuit. Similar lines, we have to draw the connection diagram of this burglar alarm circuit, and you have to explain the operation, and you have mentioned the applications. If you have any questions, you are free to ask questions, or you can put the questions in comment box, so that we will discuss in the next video lessons. Thank you all of you for your patient listening throughout this video lesson. Feel free to comment so that we will update in the next video lessons. If there is any updations, that will be added, and next video lessons are further improved. Thank you all of you for your patient listening of this video lecture.